Ladies and gentlemen, live from the famous ACME Comedy Theater in Hollywood, welcome to tonight's presentation of Unscripted Hollywood Free for All. And now please to welcome our director, Joseph Limbaugh.
Part of our studio audience for this online television show, Unscripted Hollywood Dream Roll! What you will see tonight is a Hollywood blockbuster. And we're going to create this blockbuster with no set, with no budget, and with no script.
Yay!
Yay! Is correct! That is the correct response. We couldn't have a blockbuster if we didn't have a Hollywood star. So, ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you Vivian Bang! Awesome. Vivian, here you are, Hollywood dream role. Finally. What is your dream role?
I chose John Hughes, teenage romance.
Yeah. All right, some John Hughes fans. Awesome. Sort of an angsty teenage romance. What made you choose that?
I just grew up with it, learned my English watching it, so.
Awesome. Great. So we might learn some things tonight. How much improv experience do you have?
Zero.
Yay! Awesome. You are the perfect candidate. All right, so. We are going to create your dream role. We'll get some stuff from the audience now. So to start off with, we need a name for her. What's a name for a heroine in a John Hughes movie?
Pepper,
that's good. Something unusual. I like that. What was?
Bella.
Bella, yeah? What was that?
Tabitha.
Pepper, Bella, Tabitha. What do you think?
Kitty.
Kitty's good.
I like Pepper,
too.
Yeah.
Let's go with Pepper. Awesome. So that's her unusual John Hughes name. So we couldn't do the show if we didn't have some more cast. So ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you the cast of Hollywood Dream Roll! Delightful. All right, so this is a Hollywood blockbuster. So in Hollywood, we do the casting very rapidly. So you're going to cast a couple roles right now. So take a look at them and choose someone to be perhaps the wealthy boy that you can't get, but you have a crush on.
Okay.
You can go inspecting closer. Go ahead. Take a good look. Take a gander.
Okay, Jeff.
Yeah! Awesome. All right. So what's his name? Spartan. Yeah, I like it. Spartan, let's go with that. Awesome. So go get ready. Great. So Spartan. And now choose like your wacky sidekick. Could be a guy or a girl.
Brian.
Excellent. All right. So what's the name of an animal?
Oh,
I mean Weasel.
Weasel.
All right. Your name is Weasel.
Weasel.
That's your nickname. Yay. It's not that hard. Okay, and finally we need a name for this movie, something that sounds like it would be the title of a song about teenage issues. A made-up song, not a real song.
Dry hump.
What's a dry hump? There's more options coming.
It'll clear up with ointment.
What's that?
It'll clear up with ointment.
It'll clear up with ointment? We're getting closer. Yeah, I like that. Mom said it was okay. So what do you think?
I like it'll clear up with ointment.
I like that too, yeah. It'll clear up with ointment. So ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you Unscripted Hollywood Dream Roll!
In a world without plot, in a land without script, one celebrity will find themselves with the opportunity of a lifetime. A chance to play their dream role. The only catch is, there is no set, there is no budget, and there is no script. Will this be a dream role or a nightmare? Let's find out tonight in our star-studded presentation of Hollywood Dream Roll.
Starring Jeff Ahern, Dave Cox, Kate Danley, Brian Giovanni, Beth Leckbee, Josh Paget, Carolyn Wilson, and our special guest star tonight, Vivian Bang.
And the principal is sitting behind his desk, and his assistant is there, whoever the principal's assistant is. Coming into the classroom is Pepper. She's just transferred to this school, so she'll enter the scene when we start. Wait, don't start, don't enter yet. Want to be a surprise. All right, and so we're all set up. Principal's office, principal's assistant, and action.
Well, Mr. Hines, the kids are at it again.
More jello in the Olympic-sized swimming pool.
Yes, indeed. Oh, here. Goodness. Hi.
Hello.
Oh, it's the new girl.
The new girl! Yes. Well.
Have a seat, miss.
What's your name again? I forget.
Pepper.
Pepper?
Pepper.
Pepper. Is that some sort of nickname, missy?
No, it's my name.
Because we don't cotton to nicknames here at Williamsburg High.
It's not my nickname, it's my real name.
Oh, what a shame.
Yes, quite a shame. Quite a shame. You're up for a lot of teasing, I'm afraid. Well, which group are you going to fit in with? The jocks, the dweebs, the dildos, the dweebies, the burnouts, the brains, the cheerleaders,
the
hotheads, the socias, the mechanical geniuses, dyed sweet mushrooms.
I can't take this. Can I get my class schedule?
All right, Pepper, but I have to say your day's not starting out auspiciously.
Fade out.
Junior Girl Scouts.
All right. Out in the hall are the two trainee girls and a Spartan. such unusual names. Yeah, they're all hanging out, talking about their trendy stuff, and Pepper, you'll come up at some point, and you'll run into them. But you can wait till a dramatically appropriate time. All right, action!
Spartan, guess who's got tickets to George Michael?
If you're telling me about it, I guess I do.
It's true, and I got two big boobs that are gonna go with me.
Whoa!
Oh!
Whoa!
God! Oh, what a loser!
Pay the toll!
Oh! Yeah, pay the toll! What's the toll?
I don't know yet. What's your name?
I'm Pepper. I'm new here.
Yeah, you're new here.
Pepper!
Where's the hat?
Hey!
Pistachio?
That looks like she bought it from Kmart!
Pepper!
Fade out.
All right. We're going out to the library where the nerdy sidekick of the future is sitting at study hall in the library, and Pepper comes in and sits down next to him. And action.
Hey. So you're in my English lit class, right?
Yeah.
What do you think about that Camus guy?
You know, it's weird. A lot of the existentialists say that Camus is more like ahead of his time, and if you read The Stranger, it seems like the main character is schizophrenic, but that's just...
I sort of get it, you know? Like, I sort of get, you know, like, killing someone because, like, the sun's in your eye.
I know. It's like the strangest thing to happen for any reason at all. And that's just how life works.
Yeah, I find, like, life really strange, too. You know? Like, I feel like people don't really understand me.
I understand you, Pepper. I think that's how high school kind of works. You don't really know why you're here or what you're supposed to understand, but if you make a connection with somebody, then...
I don't know. I've never really made a connection with anyone. Like, especially not in high school.
Well... I can be your friend, Pepper. I mean, if you ever want to, you know, hang out and grab a smoothie or talk about Camus or...
I love smoothies.
You know, I heard our next session is going to be on Jean-Paul Sartre and his views on transcendentalist existentialism.
Oh my god, I just did a performance art piece about that.
Oh my god.
Yeah. What's your name?
What traders call me Weasel?
Weasel. I'm gonna write that in my journal.
You know, I don't have a journal because I'm trying to be ironic, you know?
Yeah, like, I get it.
Like, I can record thoughts without having something there, like a tangible item to have. It's weird. It's weird, I guess.
No, I know what you're talking about.
Wow.
Yeah.
You're like the first person who ever... got me.
Well, you're kind of like the first person that I've ever talked to for more than like 5 minutes.
Me too.
Cool. Do you want to go get lunch?
Yeah, I'm starving. Let's go. Bye, it's
Mommy
Joe.
Make a connection. Reach out and find.
All right. We now go to the two clicky girls, and they're talking about Pepper, and they're making some sort of evil plan. And this is in, we'll say it's in the locker room. And action!
God. I hate her so much.
Me too.
God, it just...
She makes me want to sneeze.
Pepper, you are the funniest person I know. I know a lot of people too. Anyway, what I was thinking is, we need to show that new girl just where she is in the pecking order of this high school.
You know what? I think you are absolutely right, Tiffany. God, we need to show her that she can't just come around dumping her books all over our guy and thinking that maybe she can, like, talk to us and jump.
Ugh. Yeah, and wake me up before you go-go. Did you see how she looked at Spartan?
Oh my god, get me with a spoon! That was totally
funny. Let's go, girls! Out on the field now!
Fade out. Alright, we now cut to out on the field where the coach, the PE teacher we just saw is talking to the two girls and Pepper. They're all out on the field, yeah. Here we go. Action!
Alright, doing pop-ups!
She fell in the air! Caught it! Here, Pepper, why don't you catch it?
What is that about?
Nothing, I was just trying to make Pepper seem included.
Miss Man Coach? I mean, I don't think we should be punished because she can't catch a ball.
I think she can. Catch a ball. Pepper caught in the air.
Sorry.
But she didn't drop it. Way to go.
Classy.
Hey, listen. I'm sick of you and your clique. Always thinking you're better than everybody else.
Do you know who my father is, Coach Woman?
Yes, everybody in town knows that your father is the assistant mayor.
Did you hear that, Pepper?
Mm-hmm.
He's like almost mayor.
Totally almost.
Fade out. All right, another part of the field, Spartan and his jock friend are talking, and maybe his other jock friend. So you're not the principal, he's not the principal, you're the jock friend. In this. All right, good, perfect, yeah. Action.
Good look, man.
Thanks, man. I like to pop the collar. It kind of says, you know, I'm dressed up, but like fun is exploding out of my collar.
Yeah. It's like an eruption. It's a festival going on in your neck.
Yeah. Yeah. Talking about festivals, have you seen some of the new talent at the school this year?
I saw one I kind of liked a lot.
Right. Cherry?
I think it was,
Susan? April?
Yeah.
Heather? It was Lori? It was, Kim Yi. It was...
Keep going.
No, that's all of them. That's all of them.
I think her name was Pepper.
Pepper? What kind of name is that?
I think it's Dutch.
We don't want you hanging around with any Dutch people.
Yeah, man.
What's up with you, Spartan?
She ain't like Claude wearing Dutch. She's just Dutch.
Any amount of Dutch is too much Dutch for me.
Yeah. You're gonna get clogged up by that girl.
I'm not worried. I can take care of myself. There's just something about her, you know? It's the smell of her hair. She smells like...
cheese?
Lilacs.
They make cheese out of lilacs?
I think in Wisconsin they do.
They're way ahead out there.
So there are a lot of Dutch people in Wisconsin?
I don't know where the Dutch live!
You better get your act together, Spartan.
Yeah!
All right, hey, ease up on me, all right? Going through some tough times. My dad just kicked me out again.
What? Are you living up in that shack up on the hill like last time?
Yeah, I am. And I'm having a party there this weekend.
What? A party at the shack on the hill? Yeah!
Fade out. All right. Now we're after school. It's detention. And for some reason, Pepper's in detention. And so is Spartan. And so's the nerdy sidekick kid. And, there's a really boring teacher in here who's in charge of, detention. And... action!
Spartan's such a long name, it takes a while to carve into the desk.
Spartan, why are you vandalizing school property? You can get in trouble for that.
Are you talking to me like we're friends?
No, I'm sorry.
You're such a jerk, Spartan.
Forgot the R in Spartan.
My dad didn't put an R in.
Your dad was a dumbass just like you, huh, Spartan?
I don't need this.
Oh, I think you do. Listen, Spartan, you hate this high school so much, you're on a fast track to a fifth year. Back to reading Camus. Stop looking over here.
Pronounce Camus, but it's a common error. It's all right.
Shut up. I heard about your big party on the weekend.
Yeah, you can't come.
Yeah.
Not invited.
Guess what, Spartan? I'm going to be there. I'm going to be there with the whole police force. We know what you do up there. The shack on the hill. We're going to shut you down.
Ha! We're at the hill on the shack. No, actually, you were right.
Yeah, that's right. That's right, Spartan.
We're going to be on the hill, in the shack. Damn.
Found yeah, you think out. Detention sucks. Wait till you find out what solitary is like down at the county jail. Thank you.
Hey, you know, I used to forget the R in my name.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, no one's ever said that to me. And said it so beautifully, eloquently.
I don't know about that, but...
Hey, three's a crowd.
Hey, wait, you can't just...
This seems like a good time for a love montage. So we see a montage of them in different places with the nerd guy looking on from different directions.
You wouldn't burn me all the time.
Oh my God. Spartan.
It's all right. I don't ever want to see you sad.
That really sucks.
It does. It hurts a lot because he keeps burning the same spot over and over. Like it heals and does it again.
No. Sorry. Parents are jerks.
But we're not jerks. And we're not our parents. I want to take you to a magical land. I don't know where it is, but I want you to come with me.
Oh, look, I flipped right to Camus' entry in the encyclopedia.
Please. It needed to be said. He'll be fine.
I'll see you later.
All right.
Fade out. All right, the two jock guys and the two preppy girls are all talking about what's going on with Spartan and Pepper. And action.
I gotta say, I don't like what's going on.
I don't like what's going on either.
Yeah.
I don't like what's going on. Either.
No. Spartan, what is wrong with him?
Wait a minute. I can infer that you don't like what's going on, but you have not actually said it.
Oh, I totally don't like what's going on. Sorry, guys. All right,
all right, all right, all right.
I'm uncomfortable when people don't assimilate, too.
Yeah.
Sorry. Totally.
Yeah.
I'm bored. You guys are still talking to me, right?
We are. Yeah, barely. For now.
Carrie Ann, Canage, you're embarrassing us.
Sorry,
attention, students. Attention, students. Tryouts for the all-school variety show will be this afternoon at 4 p.m. in the gymnasium. All-school variety show tryouts today, 4 p.m. in the gymnasium.
We are so too cool for that.
Maybe.
Or we are totally going to do that.
And win it.
Yes.
Yes.
And you know who we have to beat? Is that Pepper Girl.
Yeah.
We've got to convince her to be in the contest, and then
have her lose.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is losing enough? Should there be pig blood involved? No, just losing. Just losing.
Fit out. All right, great. Pepper is at her locker when that girl, Beth, you come in and you're going to try to convince her to join the variety contest. And action.
Oh, hey, Pepper, right?
Yeah.
Gosh, Pepper, I've been thinking about stuff and how mean Carrie Ann and I were to you. And gosh, we just feel awful about it.
That's cool. Don't worry about it.
Oh, let's hug. Anyway, Pepper, one of the things that all the cool kids do at the school, well, I guess at any school in high school America, is they do variety shows. Well, I don't want to speak for him, but I bet Spartan would be really excited if you did your own act in the variety show.
Really?
Yeah. Do you have any talents?
Well, yeah, I can play the drums a little.
You should do that.
Okay, yeah.
All right, let's hug again. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Just a nerdy friend wanders in.
Beazle.
Pepper, did you hear they're having
a
talent
show? Yeah. I think I'm going to play performance drums.
No way. I want to play the shamisen.
Oh my god, we could be in a band together.
Really?
Yeah. That'd be so awesome.
You know, last time I tried to play the shamisen, I got laughed at, but I think if we play together, maybe I'll finally show them what a cool duo we can be.
It's going to be awesome. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Let's go practice.
All right, feed out. All right, so we now go to the variety show. Looking forward to the variety show. So we see a series of acts. So we'll see, like, lights up, and then we'll see an act, and then lights down, and then we'll just see a series of acts leading up. It's like a montage of acts leading up to Pepper's performance. All right, so get someone out there to start with. Everybody get in line, and can someone start, and action.
Same mistake my mother made.
Look, I'm always going to be there for you. But I just think Weasel might be the one. I think Weasel might be a better man for you than I ever will be.
No, Spartan, I really like you. I mean...
You like me, exactly. But you love Weasel.
Maybe. I don't know, I'm so confused. You know, I just...
I don't have a lot of money. Well, that's a big lie, actually. Fucking loaded. I'm sorry, I went into my old breakup speech where I was trying to get rid of a girl. I'm loaded, so I guess giving you this shirt isn't going to be as big a deal as it was going to be before.
Is that all I am, a girl that you're just trying to break up with? That sucks. I thought you were different.
I'm not different.
I hate you.
I'm good for you. Still a nice shirt.
Yeah. All right, Weasel is—he's up on the roof of the theater, and he's looking down. This is his special place, and yeah, Pepper comes up to him and finds him. And action!
God, what are you doing here?
Oh, this is where I come to forget about it all.
I just broke up with Spartan.
Listen,
This really sucks, you know? I really liked him. I really did.
Look, Pepper, I've seen the way you looked at him. And I saw the feelings he had for each other, but I've told
you... You know, he thinks like there's something between you and me. And it's like, hello, you're like my sister, you know? And I'm like, yeah, I love Weasel, but like, he's like... one of my dearest friends, you know, and there's nothing between us, and he thinks he's such a jerk, and then he pulled the whole rich speech. Like, I hate him.
The rich kids come in to mock her during this moment of darkness. But not Spartan, not Spartan.
Pepper, don't listen to anything they say. It doesn't matter. And you know what? I don't care that everybody's here. I don't care that you're here. I don't care that anybody else is here. I'm going to tell you right now, Pepper. I had feelings for you for the moment I looked into your eyes.
Oh, yeah. He's got love at first sight.
Yeah, you can laugh it up. It's fine. And listen.
Weasel and Pepper sitting in trees.
Shut up.
And listen, maybe we are just... I had to tell you, because
if I'm sorry,
Spartan is the one, if Spartan is the one for you, I just hope he treats you right.
I'm so sorry, I don't like you like that.
Oh, no! Weasel stands up to the rich kids.
You know what?
Yeah,
you know what?
What?
10 years from now, none of this is going to matter. All high school is 4 years of drudgery, and you might be the kings now. You might be sitting on your throne now, but 10 years from now, it's not going to make a lick of difference. And the fact that I have enough integrity to stand up for myself and not treat other like crap the way you guys do, that makes me a better person. See you guys later. And Pepper, Spartan has turned a new leaf. I hope he treats you 1,000 times as good as I would have done.
Hey, come back here, you little weasel. But it's not true, right? I mean, we're gonna be cool forever, right?
They wander off considering that.
Listen, 20 years from now, I'm gonna be sitting in my Miata drinking a wine cooler.
Okay, I had about 10 minutes to think it over.
You really hurt me, Spartan.
I was trying to hurt you. I didn't think I deserved you, but... Wow, weasels are real pussy. I totally misjudged him.
I don't know. What are you doing here?
I'm trying to say I'm sorry. And that's... I think I love you again. For what it's worth. I'm flighty.
Oh, to trust you when you keep flipping up like that?
I have a bipolar disorder. It's not something I'm proud of. But if I take my meds...
You do?
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell me that before?
Because people think I'm crazy. It's just bipolar disorder.
Spartan, I can handle that. I mean, it's just crazy.
Yeah, it's just crazy.
Sometimes love is like a rash on your face. Sometimes love can find no place. Sometimes love is a ditch, and you don't know what to do. But it will clear up with ointment when the day is through. It will clear up with love.
Comes up and he's with a girl.
Far away from here, and it goes to Pepper!